Let's learn about operators in Java. We have seen the theory section already. The link for that video is available in this video description. So as we have seen already, there are four different types of operators in Java. One is arithmetic operator, the second one is relational operator, then third one is bitwise operator, and then logical operator, that fourth one. So let's see one by one. So in this first are arithmetic operators. So what are the mathematical basic operations we need that will be available with these operations? So operators. So the first one is plus sign whenever we wanted to do addition of the two numbers. When we wanted to multiply, we can use multiply operator. Division, division operator. Then when we wanted to subtract, subtraction operator. And then we wanted to decrement any of the number by one, then we can use minus d. And the same way we can print it here. Now there is one more modulus operator where whenever we are dividing two numbers and we wanted to get remainder of the number, then we can use modulus operator. So x mod 10 or mod y mod 10. So this is 43 divided by 10. Whatever the remainder will be there, that will be given as mod 10. So whenever we try to run this, let's say whenever we are dividing, so you will see x mod 10, which is x is 43 mod 10 will be 3. So similar way for say this double number 72.25, this 2.25. so this is the operator which can give the remainder of any division of the two numbers. Then let's see assignment operator, where whenever we wanted to assign any number with some addition. Suppose a is equal to a plus 4, so this is what we wanted to write, but this can be in a simple way we can use as a plus equal to 4. The next one is similar way, a is equal to a mod 2. So this can be written as a mod is equal to 2. So the same operation can be performed in a simple way, and this can be simple way. The next one is x is equal to x plus 1, where x is equal to x plus 1, then x plus plus, when we wanted to do this, then it is just incrementing by one number. So we can write it as x plus plus. This is increment operator. Then decrement operator, whenever we wanted to decrement any variable by its 1, then we can use as y minus minus or y is equal to y minus 1. So this is a decrement operator. Then coming to, there are pre and post increment decrement operators. So pre increment is means before assigning that variable, it will be incremented. Suppose x is equal to 42 and y is equal to we are assigning this plus plus x, that means x will be incremented and then it will be assigned to y. So x is equal to, let's say 42, then whenever it will assign to y, it will become 42, 43 first, and then it will assign, because this is a pre-increment operator. Now this line can be written as x is equal to x plus 1. So x is equal to x plus 1 means x is equal to 42 plus 1 will become 43, and then that will be assigned to y as 43. Now the post increment operator, so x is equal to 42, now y is equal to x plus plus. Now what happened before incrementing, this x value will be assigned to y. So that means y value become 42, but x value become 32. 43. So this will be y is equal to x, and x is equal to x plus 1 can be written as. So these are the arithmetic and assignment operators. Now let's say there are various control statements which we also seen, if then else, if statement, then while, do while, like this. So first let's see if statement, when if statements are needed. So suppose we wanted to do some condition checking between the two variables, then we can use this condition. If a is equal to b, then we can say is a and b are equal. If a is less than b, then we can say if A is then A is less than B. So this way we can do this. Now if I try to run this, so as A and B are equal, then it gives unmeshes. So suppose I am doing this A is 30 and B is 20 and try to run it. Now it will show up like A is greater than B. So this way we can use. So this is if then else ladder, we can say with multiple conditions. Now coming to the for loop. In for loop we have whenever we wanted to so how for loop works, so let's see one by one. So I'm just trying to comment this out. Okay, in for loop what we can do, whenever this is an iteration loop where we can have this kind of line written, integer I is equal to 0, from 0 we can start, I is less than 10, so till 10 number it can run this loop and it will be incremented by one number. So if I try to run this and we will see this, how this is going to affect. So I'm just trying to print the I number here. So I is 0, I is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Because this is iterating till 9, because from 0 it is started, and as it is less than 10, and if I make it as less than equal to 10, then it will run till 10. So you will see this is 10. Now the similar way we can do it for for decrement things as well. So now you will see I have just written as I is equal to 10, from 10 it can start, and I is greater than 0, till the time it becomes 0 I wanted to decrement and I just wanted to print it here, and I also wanted to multiply it is here, and I will just type it A as here. And so now if you say this I has started from 10, and it will print as I is 10. Okay, and then it will just integer A is equal to 5 into I. So this is one statement I wanted to do some multiplication with that number. So every time it is multiplying, it become giving this line is 50, then 9 into 5 45, 8 into 5 40. So this way it will just decrement until 0, and then it will display the last result as well. So this is for loop and if then else statement, which will change the flow of the state programs. So this is what I have wanted to cover in this video. I hope you have understood this. If you have any questions, then please put it in comment section, and if you like my video, then please like it and subscribe to my channel as well. Thank you for watching.